Now I'm going to lead or lag compensator, exact. By adding zeros, by adding poles, what will happen? We have just seen. Now I'm going to lead or lag compensator. So this is similar to PD or PI or PID controller. Okay. And the lead compensator is exactly similar to the PD controller. Lead is exactly similar to PD controller. Lag and PI controller are exactly same. And lead lag PID controller is exactly same. We know that in PI controller, steady state response is improved. Steady state is improved. Okay, similarly, lag compensator also, steady state response will be improved. We know in the previous class, we discussed PD controller will improve the transient response. Same behavior will be there in the lead compensator. Same behavior can be seen in the lead compensator. Now, both can be combined, both the above two advantages, transient response improved, steady state response improved, can be combined in PID controller. So lead lag compensator, both the advantages we can obtain. Now we are going to lead compensator separately, separate discussion on lead compensator, entire behavior or characteristics of lead compensator. Circuit diagram, this is the circuit diagram. What we are trying to do is transfer function for this lead compensator circuit diagram. So transfer function is nothing but output by input, Laplace transform. Okay, Laplace of output by Laplace of input is the transfer function. So output voltage is E naught. So E naught of S divided by EI of S. We are taking output side R2, a constant. If R2 is there, Laplace transform is R2 only. Okay, this is time domain. This is frequency domain. Frequency domain or Laplace transform is one and the same. If we have C capacitor, if we have C capacitor, then 1 by Cs is the Laplace transform for capacitor. 1 by Cs is the Laplace transform for capacitor. If we have inductor, if we have inductor L, then L into S is the Laplace transform. L into S is the Laplace transform. These are basic details we know in time domain and frequency domain. Now output we are having R2. So R2 divided by, then it is a series combination. It is a series combination R2 and the parallel of R1C. And the parallel of R1C. So parallel of R1C equivalent is nothing but R1 into 1 by Cs divided by R1 plus 1 by Cs. Okay, this is the equivalent for the parallel combination. Equivalent for the parallel combination. So you can see here it is present in the denominator second term. It is present in the denominator second term. I told you capacitor means 1 by Cs we will write in the bottom. I have written bottom left. I have written for capacitor it is 1 by Cs. Parallel combination means product divided by sum. Okay, product of R1 and 1 by Cs and the sum of R1 and 1 by Cs. Okay. And now upon simplification, we are getting a transfer function like this. This is the final transfer function. And we have seen the general format is S plus 1 by tau and denominator S plus 1 by alpha tau. S plus 1 by tau, S plus 1 by alpha tau. Okay. So in the place of tau, we are having in the place of tau, this is 1 by tau. Okay. Numerator, you can see. Numerator, you can see this term 1 by R1C and here we have 1 by R1, 1 by tau and hence tau value is nothing but, tau value is nothing but R1C. Tau value is nothing but R1C. Okay. So similarly in the denominator second term, you can see denominator second term, you can see in the place of tau already we have R1C. In the place of tau already we have R1C. And only alpha is left. Okay, only alpha is left. So this complete is nothing but alpha value. This complete is nothing but alpha value. And here is the alpha in denominator. So here comes the alpha value. R2 by R1 plus R2. Okay, this is the alpha present in the denominator. Alpha present in the denominator. You equate and find out the, okay, let this be equation number 2. And equation number 3, by comparing equation 2 and 3, we got the tau value and alpha value. Okay, these things are important. In lead compensator, alpha value is less than 1. We have seen here star mark box, star mark and box. Alpha value is nothing but 0 by pole, and it is a value less than 1. Already we got the alpha in the next term is R2 by R1 plus R2. R2 by R1 plus R2. This is a value less than 1. This is a value less than 1. This is about lead compensator. And now coming to the maximum lead. This is the transfer function. This is another fashion of transfer function. Lead compensator transfer function. Lead compensator transfer function. Another form. Alpha into 1 plus j omega tau divided by 1 plus j omega alpha tau, where alpha value is less than 1. Alpha value less than 1. Write the angle GC of j omega. Write the angle. We will have equation number 4. Angle. This angle is called maximum lead. This is a lead compensator. So maximum lead in lead compensator. This is pi. Pi not alpha. So pi is nothing but maximum lead. Pi is nothing but maximum lead. And that in equation 4, apply tan on both sides. Okay. Apply tan on both sides in equation 4. Okay. Then what we will have? Tan of A minus B is nothing but, okay. Tan of A minus B is nothing but tan A minus tan B divided by 1 plus tan A tan B. 1 plus tan A tan B. Okay. Using this formula, we got equation 5. Using this formula, we got equation 5. Further simplification is done over here. Further simplification is done over here. To find only pi value in equation 5, on further calculation, this is the formula for tan pi, and pi is the maximum lead. Pi is the maximum phase lead in lead compensator. Maximum phase lead in lead compensator. And hence, pi m can be written as tan inverse 1 minus alpha by 2 root alpha. 1 minus alpha by 2 root alpha. This is the formula for maximum lead in lead compensator. Formula for maximum lead in lead compensator. Or another formula we have, 1 minus alpha by 1 plus alpha. 1 minus alpha by 1 plus alpha. Phi m is nothing but sine inverse 1 minus alpha by 1 plus alpha. This is also another formula. Okay, this is also another formula. Maximum lead can be given in two different ways. Maximum lead can be given in two different ways. Let me take it as equation number 6a and 6b. Equation number 6a and 6b. Both are equations for maximum lead only. Both are equations for maximum lead only. And if we calculate the magnitude, it is 1 by root alpha. And phase angle is pi m. Maximum lead is nothing but phase angle. Magnitude is nothing but 1 by root alpha. In the previous slide, you can see frequency at which maximum lead occurs. Frequency at which maximum lead occurs. That frequency is omega m. And the formula is 1 by t root alpha. 1 by t root alpha. This is the formula for frequency at which maximum lead occurs. In lead compensator, frequency at which maximum lead occurs. This I will make it as equation number 7. Okay, I will tell you what all you have to remember. We have seen number of calculations. Okay. And you have to remember the alpha formula. If possible, alpha formula, R2 by R1 plus R2, it is a value less than 1. And then you have to remember equation number 7 and 6A, 6B. Okay. So only these things are very, very important. So we have the advantages of lead compensator, advantages or behavior of lead compensator. It adds a pole and a zero. In the pole zero diagram, you can see pole and zero. 0 will come close to the origin. I will show you the pole 0 diagram. 0 will come to the close to the origin. You can see bottom, this is the pole 0 diagram. 0 is close to the origin. Okay, and the minus 1 by tau, minus 1 by alpha tau is the value. Pole 0 diagram, 0 followed by pole. It can be minus 1 by tau, minus 1 by alpha tau. Okay, this is the pole 0 diagram. Lead compensator, pole 0 diagram. And then damping increases means eta value increases. Rise time, settling time decreases. Rise time and settling time decreases if we use lead compensator. It improves phase margin, gain margin. Phase margin, gain margin improves. Bandwidth also increases. Bandwidth also increases. Steady state error is not affected. Steady state error is not affected. These are the behavior of lead compensator. So along with this, we have to remember what all the things we have to remember. Transfer function in lead compensator is S plus 1 by tau divided by S plus 1 by alpha tau. And tau value is R1 into C. And then alpha value is R2 divided by R1 plus R2. And the value is less than 1. Value is less than 1. Okay. So maximum phase lead is nothing but tan inverse 1 minus alpha by 2 root alpha. Other formula is sine inverse 1 minus alpha by 1 plus alpha. And the frequency at which maximum lead occurs, omega m, is nothing but 1 by t root alpha. 1 by t root alpha. These are the formulas we have to remember in the case of lead compensator. Okay. So transfer function and the tau value, alpha value, alpha is less than 1. Maximum lead, where it occurs, maximum lead, how much is the lead? Okay, so this is maximum lead and this is frequency, okay, at which maximum lead occurs. Frequency at which maximum lead occurs, that is 1 by t root alpha, 1 by t root alpha. This is time constant, tau is nothing but time constant. And we have another formula for alpha, which is nothing but 0 divided by pole. 0 divided by pole. However, the value is less than 1 in the case of lead compensator. Value is less than 1 in the case of lead compensator. Okay. All these are the details of lead compensator. Similarly, we will move on to lag compensator. We will see.